Scott Cordischi, The Extra Point Show. A look back, a look ahead with the New England Players. AM 790 Talk and Business.
Welcome back to the Cardi's Extra Point Football Show on AM 790, broadcasting live from Cardi's Furniture in South Attleboro. Scott Cordischi alongside Patriots fullback James Devlin. The Patriots coming off a 27-25 win over the Jets Thursday night. It's the Chicago Bears coming to town next Sunday to take on the Patriots. Our Cardi's Extra Point Football Show brought to you by Cardi's Furniture, Torre Plastics, North Providence Tire, Lopco Contracting, Gianni Construction, Statewide Plumbing and Heating, Alpine Auto Body, and Chrissy's Hair Salon, North Providence. And let's say hello to James Devlin. Jimmy, how are you?
I'm good, man. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thanks for joining us. Appreciate it. Congratulations on the win Thursday night.
Thank you very much.
It was a rock fight. As you know, it's funny. Some people were surprised by that. I was not.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty much what I've come to expect when the Patriots and Jets hook up.
Absolutely. I mean, it's a very bitter rivalry in the AFC East. Every game is. And, you know, we knew that they were going to give us a good fight and a 60-minute fight, and it came down to the very last second. And, you know, we're just grateful to pull it out.
I thought it was poetic justice the way it ended, because Jones was the guy that got mm-hmm. called a couple of years ago for the push.
Yeah.
And that gave them a second chance in overtime of kicking the game-winning field goal. So mm-hmm. It was poetic justice that he got
Absolutely.
The block at the end of this game.
Yeah, I didn't even realize when it happened. And then I think it was a little bit later, we were in the post-game thing, and I realized, I'm like, oh, my God, you know, Chris got that penalty last year. And
yeah
it's just it's a little bit of karma, I guess, coming back around.
No question. Well, 5-2 is not a bad place to be, mm-hmm. and you guys have the Chicago Bears coming to town this Sunday. You know, I guess it's been – you guys can't ride the emotional roller coaster that I think the fans do, and mm-hmm. I think to a certain extent the media does. And I know everybody was wondering what was going on early in the season. The team's struggling. They just don't look like themselves. And then all of a sudden, you know, after that awful loss in Kansas City, you guys bounce back in resounding fashion mm-hmm. against Cincinnati, and then you win that good division game out in Buffalo, and everybody's happy again. All is right in Patriot Nation, you know what I mean? You guys can't get caught up in that, can you?
Nah, I mean, we really try to look at every game like a one-week season, you know. After Sunday's done or Monday night or whatever it may be, we just really have to turn the page and just start preparation for the next week, because, I mean, I think you see it now more than ever in the NFL. There's so much parity. I mean, you know, like every team can beat any team on any given Sunday. I mean, look at, you know, a one-win team in the Rams beat, you know, the Super Bowl champions of last year.
Yep.
And I think it's an incredible thing in the NFL is that, you know, any given Sunday, depending on emotion or whatever it may be, any team can beat any other team.
By the way, speaking of that win by the Rams, did you see what their punt unit did?
Oh, yeah.
The two plays, not just one. The fake punt, that was nice, but the fake punt, the punt return was awesome the way they did it. They doubled the gunner.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess the film showed that every time that guy did a sky punt, 90% of the time it would go to the left as he was kicking it.
Yeah.
So they doubled the gunner, and then they released him inside, and they made it look like the pump was going to the left, and he had a wall
right
up the right side. That was really cool. I hadn't seen that done before.
I know.
So anyway, you know, you look at what happened Thursday night, and it's – you know, I guess, I don't know if you heard the stat, the Elias Sports Bureau said it's the first time in the history of the NFL a team has had 40 minutes or more of possession,
mm-hmm.
200 or more yards rushing in a game, and no turnovers, and actually lost the football game.
Yeah.
And to me, what that says, you know, it's funny because I keep hearing people that said to me, well, the Patriots are outplayed, the Patriots are outplayed, they deserve to lose. Well, I would beg to differ in that they weren't outplayed, because the one thing that you guys did better than the Jets is you converted your opportunities in the red zone.
Yeah.
And the bottom line is you can look at every stat you want, time of possession, rushing yardage, whatever. It's points on the scoreboard. And in the end, you guys put more points on the scoreboard because of your ability to convert in the red zone, right?
Absolutely. I think we did a good job just kind of making plays when plays were needed to be made. And, you know, not that the Jets didn't, but we just seemed to – you know, make more plays at critical times. I mean, the Amendola touchdown on 3rd and 19 in the red zone. I mean, a play to that caliber hasn't been made in the NFL yet. I mean, a 3rd and 19, you know, in that point in the game, it was just a crucial play, and Danny made a great play, and and score for us. And, I mean, just the list goes on. I mean, Shane Vereen having two touchdowns. And, you know, we had guys really step up and make a lot of plays. And like you said, I mean, it doesn't really matter what happens between the whistles. It's really, you know, the points on the scoreboard.
Speaking of Amendola, I thought he was exceptional returning kicks. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's something we really haven't seen since he's come here to New England. He was terrific in that role Thursday.
Yeah, he really was just hitting it hard. He was going and putting a lot of confidence in us as blockers in front of us and just running like a – I mean, he's running hard, man. He's running like a little Tasmanian devil back there.
And you mentioned Shane Vereen. So, obviously – there is slack that has to be picked up now with the injury to Stephen Ridley. Now, that falls on your shoulders, Shane Vereen's shoulders, Brandon Bolden, James White, Jonas Gray. I guess collectively you guys are all going to have to pick up that slack because that's a big loss. He's a good player.
Absolutely. I mean, you don't just plug in another guy when it's a guy like Rid, you know. I mean, he was the heartbeat of our team. He ran so hard, you know, gave everything he had to this team. And, you know, so we know that, you know, we collectively have to, you know, pick up that slack. And I mean, it's kind of the next man up in the NFL. I mean, injuries happen every day. And, you know, the next person's got to be ready. And in this case, it's, you know, four or five of us that have to really step up and put it on our shoulders to kind of give the team what Ridd brought to the team.
Tell me a little bit about Jonas Gray, undrafted, on the practice squad, out of Notre Dame, big kid.
Mm-hmm.
I know he got in for some snaps the other night on Thursday night and did well.
Mm-hmm.
If you could describe him, is he a similar back to like a LeGarrette Blount who was teammates with you last year and that he's one of those big bruising backs? How would you describe Jonas Gray?
I think Jonas is a little bit in it. I mean, he's in his own zone, you know.
Yeah.
I wouldn't really say he's like a Ridley. I wouldn't say like he's a LeGarrette Blount. I mean, he has those characteristics. I mean, he's a big, you know, chiseled guy. I mean, you look at him and he's just like someone carved him out of marble. I mean, he's very well built, and he runs very, very hard. He's not afraid to just lower his pads and kind of, you know, run through a couple linebackers or safeties. And, you know, it's always fun to block for a guy like that. You know, you might have, you know, 9 or 10 guys blocked, and if you leave one or two for him, you know, he's gonna try to, you know, just run him over and get the nasty yards. So, you know, he's a great player, and he's gonna do great things, you know, in his career. And I think that, you know, he's definitely a good guy to have when someone like Rig goes down.
You guys have also had to deal with some injuries up front to the offensive line and some changes up there. I mean, we all know that, you know, Logan was traded before the start of the season. Yet the one thing that I think the team's done pretty well the last few games is giving Tom time to throw the football. He needs a pocket to operate out of, and I think that you guys have done a good job in that the last few games.
Absolutely. I think our offensive line is really starting to come together as a cohesive unit. There's a lot of trust right now between the guys, and I think they communicate very well. And, you know, there's a couple guys that, you know, don't really have a ton of experience, and there's a couple guys that have a ton of experience. I mean, you know, Nate Solder, you know, Sebastian Vollmer and Dan Connolly, those are Ryan Wendell. They're guys that have played, you know, multiple seasons here. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they're really, you know, they're like the dogs out there, man. They're in the trenches every day, just, you know, giving it their all. And, you know, the young guys that have stepped up big time, Josh Klein, Jordan Devy, you know, those guys are really, you know, they're playing their butts off right now, and they're really, you know, giving us good plays when we need them.
James, I could sense a little frustration on the part of Tom Brady, understandably so, when you guys weren't clicking on all cylinders early in the season. Now it seems like there is more continuity and more plays are being made on a weekly basis these past few weeks. Was that frustrating for you? I mean, you guys obviously knew you had the talent, but it wasn't gelling. It wasn't all coming together early in the season, and now it does seem to be clicking more regularly.
Yeah, it's absolutely. I mean, we were all frustrated, you know, when we were 2-2, and we were coming off that loss on Monday night to the Chiefs. I mean, you know, we really had to dig deep and just start preparation because we knew that we had it. We knew that we had the talent and we had the scheme and everything was just right there. But we just needed to kind of show it. We needed to go out and play to our ability. And there wasn't, you know, anything that we could do but prepare and get better and just keep grinding until it started to show. And, you know, thankfully the past couple of weeks have kind of gone our way, but, you know, I think there's plenty of room for improvement, you know, still. You know, we're almost halfway through the season and we're still climbing. We still have to just keep putting in the work and getting better every week.
A guy that excites me is Tim Wright, in that I just think he gives another weapon to your offense, and I almost feel like you have that two tight end dynamic that you had when you had Gronk and Hernandez together a few years ago. And Wright's that guy, converted receiver, so real good athlete, maybe a tough matchup for some linebackers or safeties in coverage. And, you know, we're starting to see a little bit more of him these past couple of weeks as well. He's had been in the end zone a couple of times here.
Yeah, Tim's been doing a great job, and he's, you know, really, you know, from day one just came in, started to really get to know this offense, because it's tough to come in and have 1 week of preparation and play that Sunday, you know, and he's done a great job. It took him a little bit, but I think he's starting to really feel it. He's starting to get into his groove, and you know, he's out there making plays and doing a great job.
You know, we heard a lot about the quick turnaround going from a Sunday to a Thursday night game, and every team has to do it in the league. Every team plays a Thursday night game. What's your thoughts on that? I mean, listen, both teams are in the same boat, so it's not like an advantage for the Jets as opposed to the Patriots or vice versa. You both have the quick turnaround, but what's your thoughts on that? I mean, literally, the game's over Sunday, and then all of a sudden, you know, you're playing 4 days later.
Yeah, I mean, it takes away from a little bit of the preparation that we're used to. But, I mean, the coaches do a great job in kind of condensing the, you know, the usual 4 or 5 day, you know, of preparation that we usually get into like three, you know, or
do you
really
go
two.
Full pads any of those days? Are you shells, or
we
what
did,
are you doing?
No, we were just in shells. Yeah. It was mainly just walk through tempo. We had 1 day of kind of going through just to get timing down, and but it's a lot of film study and a lot of just trying to get to know your opponent, you know, personally, you know, their personnel and what they're gonna do. And you know, it's a little bit different because you don't have that time. You don't have the time to go out there and run through all your plays two or three times. You really only have a chance to go out there and do it maybe once. So, you know, you just got to go out there. It's one of those things. It's, you know, no one in the league, you know, gets that extra advantage on a Thursday night game, like you said. So everyone's in the boat together, and you know. I think in the beginning of the year when teams were still trying to fill themselves out, and you saw there was something like after the first four weeks of the season, the margin of victory on Thursday night games were like 46 points or something.
Blowouts, yeah.
So, but you know, recently the Texans and the Colts had a close game. We had a close game with the Jets. So it's all starting to come together, and teams are starting to find their identity and, you know, just play well on Thursday night.
All right, Patriots fullback James Devlin is our guest. It's the Cardi's Extra Point Football Show. We'll be back with more right after this.
Scott Cordischi, the Extra Point Show. A look back, a look ahead with the New England Players. AM 790 Talk and Business.
Welcome back to the Extra Point Football Show on AM 790. Scott Cordischi alongside Patriots fullback James Devlin. We're at Cardi's Furniture in South Attleboro, and our Cardi's Extra Point Football Show brought to you by Cardi's Furniture, also brought to you by Torre Plastics America, North Providence Tire, by Lopco Contracting, Gianni Construction, Statewide Plumbing and Heating, Chrissy's Hair Salon, North Providence, and Alpine Auto Body in Providence. Well, James, I know you guys don't look at it, but we do as fans. You guys are heading into a pretty tough stretch in the schedule. Mm-hmm. I know all you're looking at right now is the Chicago Bears.
Yep.
You know, you're singularly focused on Chicago. But when I look at the schedule, I'm like, wow, this is going to be a tough stretch, because you look at all the teams you're playing, and pretty much all of them are teams that I think are considered legitimate playoff contenders. Chicago, Denver, San Diego, Detroit. Who am I leaving out there? I know there's a couple. I'm sorry? Green Bay, exactly.
Yeah.
Another one. So this is going to be a pretty tough stretch for you.
Absolutely. You know, and like you said, we as players and coaches, we really just try to take it 1 week at a time, and we're, you know, all our focus is on Chicago right now. But, I mean, you're definitely right. You know, we got some tough teams coming up, but that's the NFL. I mean, it wasn't an easy stretch these past, you know, seven games.
Yep.
It's been a war almost every game, and you know, you just got to prepare, you know, for that every week.
You say that's the NFL. There's something else about the NFL that scares the hell out of me about this Sunday's game, and that is the Chicago Bears, I think, are in a similar situation to where you guys were coming out of Kansas City.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty angry and pretty down after what happened. They lost at home to Miami. I know some stuff was said in the locker room, but they felt like it was a game they should have won. They did not play well. So this, to me, is a circle the wagons moment for the Bears,
yeah,
like it was for you guys after the Kansas City games. And, you know, I've seen enough of this in the NFL where you guys better be ready because you're going to get their best on Sunday.
Absolutely. Yeah, and we understand that. I mean, you know, the NFL and football as a whole is really a game of emotion, you know, and we just have to bring it on Sunday. You know, we know that Chicago is going to come in here. Like you said, they're very angry. You know, they're a team with the chip on their shoulder. They have something to prove right now. And I think that, you know, we're definitely just going to have to, you know, take that and just give our own energy. And at least we got them at home. You know, that's a nice thing.
Right.
And our fans can help us out and you know, get that place rocking. And, you know, I think it'll be a great game, but, you know, we'll prepare for the best.
It's a violent, physical sport, and I understand injuries are part of the game, but you had to feel for Gerard Mayo when he went out for the season after what he went through last year to have to go through it again, granted a different injury. But it seems like he's one of those guys, one of those emotional and physical leaders on the football team.
Absolutely. Gerard, I mean, he's really one of the heartbeats of our team. I mean, when you look at our offense, you think Tom Brady. When you look at our defense, you think Gerard Mayo. You know, he's like the quarterback of the defense. You know, he's our play caller. He's, you know, he's our bell cow over there. I mean, he's a great linebacker. You know, he should be a perennial Pro Bowler. I mean, he's had to battle through some injuries last year, and of course this year now, it's really tough to see a guy like that. You know, a guy that really gives his all every week to our team, and it's tough to see him go out.
All right, so I put up a picture of you a couple of weeks ago in the locker room at Brown for our players to see. Did you see the Boston Globe, that full two-page picture of you celebrating in the end zone?
No.
Touchdown? I think it may have been the Cincinnati game. And it was in the sports section a couple of weeks ago. It's you jumping up in the air celebrating, I think, with Tim Wright after his touchdown. And so I put it up in the locer room. And the Brown football coaches are busting your chops. Nobody celebrates a touchdown better than James Devlin.
Yeah, I got a reputation for that right now. But, hey, that's football, man. I mean, you're supposed to have fun.
No question. It is emotional.
Plays. Absolutely. I mean, I'll always be the first guy down there, you know, running, trying to pat the guy on the head when he makes a good play. And, you know, I have no shame in that. That's the game.
Can I tell you something? And I love that because – like when things weren't going well, that's one of the things I wanted to see more out of Tom. You know, Tom at times was a little stoic on the sideline, and I want to see guys fired up even when things aren't going well.
Yeah.
You know, you on the sideline or him on the sideline pumping everybody up. Let's go. Let's get this thing going. And I like to see that emotion because I agree with you. It's an emotional sport.
Absolutely.
If you don't play with emotion, you're not going to go very far in this league.
Yeah. We got some guys that really bring emotion. I mean, you know, Rob Gronkowski, Julian Edelman, Danny Amendola, Tom Brady. I mean, he's the ultimate competitor.
Yeah.
You know, you can see him on any given Sunday. Just, you know, he's got the eye of the tiger, so they say. And, you know, we got a good group, and, you know, we bring a lot of emotion to the table.
All right. Any plans for the bye week in a couple of weeks, or you can't even think about that?
I can't even think about that right now. I mean, that's in the future. We're all about Chicago right now.
All right. James, thanks as always for joining us. It's great having
you. Thank you, man.
James Devlin, Patriots fullback, our guest here on the Cardi's Extra Point Football Show.